Ranger Bill, warrior of the woodland, struggling against extreme odds, traveling dangerous trails, showing rare courage in the face of disaster. In the air. On horseback. Or in a screaming squad car. Ranger Bill, his mind alert, a ready smile, unswerving, loyal to his mission. And all this in exchange for the satisfaction and pride of a job well done.
Christ, Christ, our Savior was born under Christmas Day.
You sound chipper today, Stumpy.
And why not? It's Christmas time again. This is the only time of the year when every station on the radio plays music it's worth listening to.
I'm sure you'll find a lot of people agree with you there, old-timer.
And a lot of people who disagree.
Say, talking about Christmas and the like, how's that pageant coming along you and your boys' club are putting on?
Pretty well. We have a lot of details to work out, but so far everyone's helping out real well. We've been given permission to use the school's auditorium.
Is it going to be that big an affair?
Oh, sure. We're going all the way this year. A pageant, music, while we're even...
Henry, you there?
Just open your eyes, Wally. I'm right here with Bill and Stumpy.
Oh.
Boy, have I got news for you.
Well, let's have it.
Look.
What is it? Let me see.
Here, I'll read it to you. Dear Wally, I would be very happy to sing for you and the young people of Knotty Pine in your Christmas program. I am available on the date you mentioned and will plan to be there. And it's signed Bill Pearce. How about that?
He can make it, huh? Boy, that's great. Did you hear that, Bill?
I sure did, pal. I didn't know you were writing to Bill Pearce to sing at your pageant. I guess you really are going all the way, huh?
I told you.
I just can't place it. I keep running it through my head over and over, but I just can't come up with it.
Come up with what, Stumpy?
Who this Bill Pearce feller is.
You know, Stumpy. He makes records. Christian records.
Oh, yeah, of course. Now I remember. Say, you really are going all out for this shindig of yours. Now I'm positive I won't want to miss it.
We've got to get right to work. The stage over in the school auditorium's pretty small for the big pageant we're planning to put on.
Yeah, so we're going to build a larger platform on the front of it.
Does the school know about that?
Sure. We showed them the plans for the thing. They thought it'd be all right.
Everybody's out on vacation right now, so we won't disturb anything or anybody.
But we have to get right at it. We want to start practicing the pageant on the platform as soon as possible.
Sounds as though it'll be some production, Henry.
We hope it'll be good, Bill. If we make a success of it this year, maybe they'll let us do something like it every year.
I hope you aren't forgetting one thing in all these plans, pal.
What's that, Bill?
I hope you're remembering in all of this what Christmas is really all about.
Ranger Bill, Henry was the guy who put this whole thing together. And I never saw such a good, well, a sermon, you might say. If anyone goes away from our boys' club pageant without knowing just who came at Christmas and why, well, it won't be our fault, that's all.
I'm glad to hear that, Wally.
And with Bill Pearce himself coming to do the singing, it should be really great.
Hey, let's keep that going. Hey, be sure those two big pieces fit together, Hank. We don't want anybody falling through the platform during the pageant.
Okay.
Sure is looking good, Wally. Just like that picture in the book on how to do it.
I know. Boy, it sure is surprising the things you can find in books.
There's Henry and Wally over there.
Yep, I see them.
Hey, it's Bill and Stumpy. Come on over and see what we're building.
Hey, come on, you guys. Get to
That's
work.
Just what we plan to do, Henry. Hey, it all looks very impressive.
Looks like you're building the lowest roof I ever saw.
Oh, it's not a roof, Stumpy. It's a platform.
Well, how come it goes over the top of the seats that way?
Well, it goes over the top of the seats for the first two or three rows. See, we use those seats to help support it. It's what they call an apron stage. You just tie it to the seats to hold it.
Very clever, pal. Gives you a lot more room to put your pageant on, and doesn't seem to take a great deal of work to build.
Yeah, and the book said that you could take it down again when you don't want it anymore.
The school said they might be interested in buying it from us if it works. So we're making it real sturdy.
There might be a few other good reasons for making it good and strong.
Yeah, like all the kids who are going to walk on it.
We're going to have the wise men enter from back there, Bill, and come all the way down this center aisle.
Uh-huh. That's right. And over there is the place where we're going to have Bill Pearce sing from.
Well, you sure seem excited by all this, Wally. Especially about Bill Pearce coming to sing.
Who wouldn't be? It isn't every day that somebody like that comes to Knotty Pine. Oh, excuse me.
Hey, Hank, you got that part on backwards. Turn it around. Nobody wants to see the back of a manger.
Well, Henry, I'll have to admit that these are the biggest preparations for a Christmas pageant I've ever seen in this town.
Boy, I can hardly wait to start the rehearsals on our new stage.
Now listen to this, Henry.
Okay, Johnny, play the sheep. No. No, the sheep. The sheep.
The lion ate the sheep.
Well, anyhow, we have some good sound effects records of sheep to use in the shepherd scene.
Sounds like Johnny's getting carried away with those records we bought.
I'll say.
Hey, Johnny, how about it, huh? Let's cut the corn.
Okay, everybody. Now, this is the way we'll work this part of it. The wise men come in from back there and walk all the way down the aisle. While they're coming, Wally will read his part standing over there. Now, let's try it. Get into your places.
Okay.
How about some sheep? Good. Now the wise men start in, and Wally reads.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him.
That's good. Now, Herod comes down here to meet them and moves in close. We want to get the idea right away that he's bothered by the thought there might be another king around. Go on, Wally.
When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born.
Wait a minute. Johnny. Hey, Johnny.
What do you want?
We didn't need all that noise in there.
Have all the people of Jerusalem gathering together.
It drowned out Wally.
So, everybody's heard this story a million times anyhow. I was just trying to make things a little different.
Well, we don't need the Christmas story made any different. It's just right the way it stands.
Boy, the way you guys act. It's just a story.
What do you mean, just a story?
Oh, listen, gang. Let's try that part again a couple of times without the sound effects. I want to talk to Johnny.
Now, what's the matter?
Do you really believe what you just said, Johnny?
Well, sure I do. My father says Christmas is just one big racket made up by businessmen to sell a lot of stuff at the end of the year.
But what about the first Christmas? What does your father say about that?
I don't know. I think he thinks it's all just a big story, that's all.
You think it is too, huh?
Well, why should I go against my father? He's been around. He ought to know.
Well, there are a lot of men who've been around, just like your father, and a lot of them think that the Christmas story really happened.
Yeah? So? A lot of them don't, too.
And they also think that the baby born on that first Christmas was important to them. As a matter of fact, still is important to them.
I know the whole story, Henry. I read the script you wrote for this pageant.
Most of it is taken right straight out of the Bible, Johnny. Doesn't that mean anything to you?
Nope. My father says the Bible isn't any different from any other book.
That's a funny thing to say.
Why?
Well, because Lots of books are different from other books.
Huh?
Sure, you don't read the dictionary the same way you read Tom Sawyer. They're completely different. And the Bible's completely different, too.
Well, he probably didn't mean it just that way. What makes a Bible so special?
Haven't you ever read it?
No. We don't have one at home.
Well, we read from it every week at club meeting. Don't you feel something special about it then?
I never listen. I don't understand all the these and thous.
Listen, Johnny. I want you to do me a favor. Will you do it?
Maybe.
I want you to take this little Bible of mine home and I want you to read...
The whole thing?
I'm afraid that'd take too long, but I want you to read just the Gospel of John. Here, I'll mark it for you. Read it all the way through 3 or 4 times. This is Christmas vacation time, so you don't have anything to keep you from it.
Okay, so I read it. Then what?
Well, then I want you to come back and tell me what you think. Tell me what you don't understand. Maybe we'll take a little time and talk about it then, okay?
Sure. I'll give it a try.
What?
Well, I hope my father don't get wind of this. I don't think he'd like it if he knew I was reading the Bible.
Hey, look at Hank. That beard makes him look like a real old man.
That's the idea, Wally. Once everyone gets into their costumes and wigs and beards, probably won't even recognize anyone.
Boy, I wish I was something more than a narrator. Don't I get anything to disguise myself?
Maybe we can give you a long robe. Will that be all right?
It's better than nothing.
Oh, say, I just remembered. I wanted to talk to you about a word you say in the pageant.
Am I making a mistake?
A little one. How do you pronounce M-Y-R-R-H?
M-Y-R-R-H. Myra.
That's the way you say it in the pageant, too.
That's wrong, huh?
Uh-huh. It's myrrh, like gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Oh, myrrh. Got it. Is that all?
For now. Have you seen Johnny around today?
I think he was back by the record player a few minutes ago. Hey, did you get him all straightened out?
He's got a lot of things to learn about God, Wally. We can all help him a lot by praying for him and showing him what Christ does for us in our lives.
Gotcha, Henry.
I'm going back to see if he's still there. Oh, there you are, Johnny.
Hi, Henry. Well, I did what you said.
What did you find?
I guess it isn't as hard to understand as I thought it was. But it's kind of got me bothered.
Oh?
Yeah. If all the things that it says are true, you know, like every man being a sinner and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that means me too, doesn't it?
That's right, Johnny. It means all of us.
Well, if that's right, and the other things that it says are right too, like, well, you know, like the way Jesus is supposed to have been punished for all of us. Well, if that's true, why isn't everybody a Christian?
That's a good question, Johnny. I used to wonder about that a lot.
You used to?
Uh-huh. Until they started giving everyone polio shots.
Polio shots? Well, what's that got to do with this?
Well, I said to myself, if this stuff is so good, why doesn't everybody get their shots? It's already proved to work, but still not everybody goes after them.
Yeah, that's right. I never thought of that. My father doesn't have his shots yet.
Well, what I figured out was that it wasn't the shots that were to blame. It was the people that didn't take them that were making the mistake.
And you think it's the same way with what the Bible says?
That's about the size of it.
Henry, I got to think this all over.
You do that, Johnny. I don't want to push you or anything, but maybe if you listen to the Christmas story with the idea that this was a man who lived a perfect life and died the death of a bad man just for you, well, maybe it will make more sense to you.
All right, I'll do that, Henry. I'm not making any promises other than that I'll listen, but I will do that.
Good, Johnny. Now, let's see if everyone has their costumes on. I'd like to start this... Oh, Wally?
I just came over to tell you that we're all ready to start. How you doing, Johnny?
Okay, Wally.
Good. Let's start the rehearsal. Tomorrow night's the big night. I want our pageant to be at least as good as I know Bill Pierce's singing will be.
Come on, Johnny. We just got a few of these posters left, and then we can get back to the school.
Boy, this sure was a good idea of Henry's, huh? To change the posters every 3 days? People see the same poster over and over, and pretty soon it's just like they don't see it at all.
I know. It gets to be kind of like a piece of furniture. But this changing bit sure takes a lot of work.
Oh, it's worth it, though. We want to get as many people to come out and see it as possible.
Hey, you know, it sounds like you're really getting excited about the pageant, too.
Well, Henry and I have been having some pretty good talks about all this stuff. I think he just might have the right idea about things.
I think he has, too. You know, I'd be lost in more ways than one if I didn't have Jesus Christ as my friend and my Savior.
But if I could only get away from thinking it was all kid stuff.
That shouldn't be hard. Well, look at Ranger Bill, or Stumpy. Or how about some ministers? I know. Wait till you see Bill Pearce tonight. You know, the guy that makes all those records? None of those fellows are kids, you know.
I'll see. It all makes pretty good sense to me, but... Hey, look out!
Hey!
Wally!
Bill, did the doctor say how he is?
We can go in, Henry.
Oh, good.
I'm afraid there's little hope of his leaving here for a good many weeks.
Oh, no.
In here, behind this screen.
Hello, Wally.
Hi, Henry. Bill?
Hi, Wally.
I guess I let you all down, didn't I?
No, you didn't, Wally. It was just an accident. That driver couldn't stop. That's all.
I know. But I should have been looking where I was going. I had those posters... Well, I guess you can get somebody else to do the narrating tonight.
I guess I'll have to do it. I'm about the only one who knows how things are supposed to go. Breaking in somebody else would just take too long.
We sure are sorry that you'll have to miss the pageant.
The pageant? Bill Pearce? And everything.
Well, it's not like you've really missed it, Wally. I mean, you've been in on it from the beginning.
Yeah, but it's not the same.
I know.
So... Here I lay, with my leg hanging in the air, while all you guys are having a good time at the pageant.
Yeah, and the doctor says you'll be here for a couple of weeks.
No, I don't care about a couple of weeks. All I want to do is be there tonight.
I know how you feel, Wally. But you can help out tonight if you really want to.
Me? Hey, what can I do?
Well, we all agree that this is to be more than just a show tonight, don't we? I mean... Don't we all hope that something important might happen in the lives of those who are attending?
Sure.
We hope that everyone will get a better idea of how wonderful it was of God to come to earth and save us.
Now, from what I've seen of the pageant, I'd say that it's very well handled to accomplish this purpose.
I hope so.
But we must always remember one thing, and that is that it's God's job to redeem people, not man's.
That's what Jesus' whole life was about, wasn't it?
Right. Now, what I'm suggesting, Wally, is that if you really want to continue to help the pageant tonight, you can, right here, by praying that God will act in the hearts of the audience and show himself to those who attend. Do you know what Mr. Pearce looks like, Stumpy?
Well, I've seen his picture on a few phonograph record jackets, but I can't say I've ever met him myself.
It's too bad Wally or Henry couldn't have come here to the airport to meet him. And, of course, Wally is in no condition to do it.
Yep, poor feller.
And Henry had to practice Wally's part. Oh, well, I think we can...
Say, look over there, that big feller with the glasses looking around. Ain't that him?
I don't know for sure. Let's go ask him. Excuse me, Mr. Pearce?
Yes. Hi. Well, you must be Ranger Bill.
That's right. And this is Stumpy Jenkins.
Howdy.
Well, I kind of expected Wally Harris to meet me here.
Poor feller.
Huh?
A young Wally was in an accident and is laid up in the hospital with a broken leg.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
He's sorry he won't hear you. He was really counting on it.
I might say his letter was very encouraging.
Well, we have instructions to take you right to the school where the Christmas program is going to be presented. this certainly is an occasion for a naughty pine, Mr. Pearce.
And believe me, this is an occasion for me too, Bill. You can call me Bill.
But I'd better go right on calling you Mr. Pearce.
Why is that, Stumpy?
Because I think there'd be too much confusion in the car going back every time I call out one of your names.
I see what you mean, old-timer.
As a matter of fact, the ride to the school is going to kind of remind me of the little old box I got sitting on my desk at home.
Well, I guess I don't quite understand.
Well, just like our car is about to be, it's full of bills.
Did you press that button again?
I'm sorry. Looks like my water pitcher's empty again.
What are you doing, pouring it out of the window?
I'm sorry to bother you, nurse.
You are not sorry to bother me. In fact, I'm beginning to think you enjoy it. This makes about the 15th time in the last hour that you wanted something.
What time is it?
9:30. Thank goodness you'll soon be asleep.
I'm sorry. It's just that, well, being here...
I know. It is hard the first few days, but you'll get used to it, and it'll be over in no time.
No, it's not that. It's the pageant.
You mean the one over at the school tonight?
That's the one. I was supposed to be in it till this happened.
That's a shame. I hear it's pretty good. Wouldn't you know, I'd have to work the evening shift tonight.
Oh, well, it's probably all over by now anyhow.
Now I see why you kept buzzing for me. You were a little lonely, weren't you?
I guess so.
Christmas is like that, you know. If you're out in it, everything is exciting and fun. But if you're cooped up inside a hospital like you are, it all seems a little drab. I guess that's why the patients like it so much when people come to sing carols.
Hey, listen.
Why, it's impossible. It's way past visiting hours. What's the meaning of all this?
I'm sorry, nurse, but it's been cleared with the supervisor. We've come to bring Wally a special visitor.
What?
The pageant went just swell, Wally.
Boy, it sure did.
And we thought that before he went back to Chicago, maybe you'd like to meet Bill Pearce.
Would I? I mean, would I?
Well, I'm sure happy to meet you, Wally. I'm just sorry you weren't up to being in the pageant.
Oh, I don't mind much. Anyway, not now, Mr. Pearce.
Well, how about singing something now, Mr. Pearce?
Would you? Hey, I...
Well, if the nurse doesn't mind, it might be too much like the groaning she hears all the time.
Oh, no, that wouldn't be it at all.
You won't care.
Come on, would you sing a song, Mr. Pearce?
Okay, okay. How about There's a Song in the Air?
Hey, I'd like that a lot.
Yeah. Okay, okay. There's a song in the air. There's a star in the sky. There's a mother's deep prayer and a baby's low cry. And the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing. O'er the manger of Bethlehem, cradles of kings. We rejoice in the light, and we echo the song that comes down through the night from the heavenly throng. Hey, we shout to the lovely evangel they bring, and we greet in his cradle our Savior.
Well, boys and girls, you can be sure that after that visit in the hospital by Bill Pearce, Wally Harris had a new understanding of the goodness of God. And so did Wally's and Henry's friend, Johnny. All of us here in Knotty Pine hope that this Christmas and every Christmas brings you to a deeper understanding of God's great goodness in His great gift, Jesus Christ.